So here's the thing that I'd like to basically have a look at. So we have this confined user, but we have some utilities that basically need root privileges. So how can we basically make it so that the user can run select utilities that need root? Now, I haven't actually tested it out before. I haven't actually implemented this before. But I'm just going to have a look, see if I can implement it. So there's this application. It's called logview. And it's a it has a GNOME desktop icon, and then when the user runs it, and then a pocket comes up, asks for the user password, and then basically the user is able to read the logs, and the logs are of course for the most part privileged, I guess. Well, actually, all users can read many of them, but anyways, not all of them though. But I'm just saying that you need root for that. So, how would I go about that? Now, so let's first just try something out and just see where it gets us. It's basically just an experimental phase. So nano my login user file context file, and then just add that in user bin log view, and then the file context. Call that log view. Now, logview is a buggy application indeed, so it might actually crash and do stuff like that. So, but at least we can just try, and if it doesn't work, we'll remove the stuff. It doesn't even have a way to close it down, actually. Logview. And then just copy the stuff over of this something that gets run by shell. Something that gets run by shell, like this here. Now, I'll be honest, I have no clue how pocket works from that perspective, so it's going to just take a lot of testing, I guess, just figuring it out. Logview, not sure if help runs Yelp, so we'll leave it out. So I guess this is it. exit module to install it. And then we're probably going to have to set up a sudoers file. And let's also have a look at the desktop file though. Let's first do that. RPM query logview. Not installed. Query file. User bin. GNOME system log. And then RPM query list that. See if we can find some. Yeah, here you have pull kit. User bin GNOME system log. Let's have a look at that. And then here you have the desktop file that I'm going to have a look at as well. So that's pretty weird. Let's have a look. At the desktop file. Seems that it's actually a GNOME system log. Lot of bullshit. Exec GNOME system log. So I guess GNOME system log actually runs logview or something like that. So what we're going to do is basically I guess add another one. Jesus. I guess that's probably fine. So Jesus log. So it's actually Jesus log that. Do it like this. Jesus log, and then edit this. I'm just experimenting. To get probably something is probably running sudo, I guess. It's no setuid application. Oh, and I see here a bug as well. So I'll fix that bug here as well. And I see other bugs as well. So basically, shell runs system log files, blah blah, and then probably what you get is that the syslog runs logview. That's what I think. Not sure. That's wrong. All right. So now that should be taken care of, I guess. Yeah, but that application is just rather buggy. I tried it a couple times and crashed all over the place. So I guess I need to I wonder how that works. Let's see how that works. Here we have a policy for log view. So what it says, this is actually old style. Out admin cute. I thought that Polkit uses JavaScript, and I don't see any actual allow active out admin keep. Thought. Let's have a look. Maybe I'm overlooking something. Don't seem to be. Well, anyways, let's just add this. I'm just going to create good question. How should I go about that? I'm just going to try something. Hell. Echo. Oh, actually, my login user. Oh, is. Oh, I should make this. Sure if this works, and then all, and I should probably limit that, and then etc sudoers d, and then my login user, and then now, in theory, that should make that stuff work, I guess. So, SE module DB. This is just experimenting. I'm going to undo this probably later on. Set and force 0. Let's try that out. Oh, actually, no, that should be fine. Let's just try that. We're in permissive mode then, so just so you are aware. So you have this logview piece of shit. Where is it? System tools. Logview. Now this is really a piece of shit application, just so you know. So, our search mhcts1357 out to allow less. There you have some nasty, nasty, nasty stuff. But with regards to, wow, look at this shit. Let's grab out the execute no trances. What's happening here? So shell runs check password. Shell runs policy kit out. And then it runs some binary, which I need to figure out what that is. And then logview runs the conf and dbus launch. So really a lot of shit going on there. Let's see what that bin file is. Hopefully that's not sudo. Oh no, that's not, of course that's not sudo. Grab bin t grab execute. PK exec. That's PK. That's basically the dialogue in dialogue that's run. So we need to take care of that first. So user, and that's user bin PK exec lsalz user bin PK exec, which is a setuid application. User bin PK exec. And what runs that? GNOME system logger. So, a lot of this is really messy. PK exec. That's basically the first thing we need to do, basically make sure that that's labeled PK exec. And I'll just copy over this stuff here. Before we can do anything at all, PK exec. And I already know that what runs it. Because I looked at the com and the com says what runs it. What actually runs it. Actually runs it is logview. Actually gsyslog. So it's not run by shell but by gsyslog. That should be taken care of. and then just restore conf pk exec. It's a setuid utility. I'm actually not sure if sudo is actually needed here. Okay, so that's set up. So let's just stop this thing if possible. So to stop this, you need to run control quit. There's no other way to stop it. There's no actually a quit button or something like that. So it's really nasty. But at least it didn't crash. So that's cool. Anyway, so let's just have a look at, see if it's created any files. Home, my login, user. And then first see cache. Doesn't seem to been creating anything there. Config. Doesn't seem to have created anything there. Local share. And doesn't seem to have created anything there either, out of the ordinary. And it's all Z root. It had root, not RPPT. It did actually create stuff here, but nothing that I should be aware of. So let's I'll search MACTS 4007 audit to allow. That's clean. PS auxy grab 10.12. That seems clean. Let's try this again. And stuff changed. Let's grab for execute no trans. So we have shell running check password, and then we have shell running policy kit out, and then we have pk exec. So pk exec is actually running logview. So that's that, we need to change that. So logview is not run by syslog, but it's actually run by pkexec, as far as I can tell. But we're going to have to verify all this stuff, because well, now we're dealing with root, so we need to be careful. Need to make sure that this stuff is done properly. There's a lot of stuff going on here. So we're at 14:10. I'm going to close this one up. Make that 14:11. Because this is not clean. This is, so let's try that again. And actually authentication was still active. Sucks. See, now stuff changed quite a bit. So yeah, you really need to be careful here, as you can see. You really need to be careful. Let's have a look. And actually this is also not right, because it was basically not doing the full dance, so quit that. At least I think. But we can also make sure of, we already know that this is happening. This is something we can be sure of. So logview is actually executing Dbus launch. So we can actually change that already. And so Dbus launch is also executed by this mother. We need to take care of the transitions first anyways. So slowly but surely we're you see the comments actually see if this exposes it, and it does. Deconf is actually running. Ouch. So that's not right. That's not right. No, that's not right. Undo. undo. Make it deconf. But something. Is missing here. Maybe deconf is then actually run by logview. Now deconf. Let's change that back. No. No, this is it. What's happening? Actually, happening is that log viewer weird. Need to make sure. I'll just log out. Make this and log out. I need to basically log out because else I'm gonna get misinformation. Need to be careful here, not to allow something that I shouldn't. Something is missing. Now I'm hanging as well, as if I haven't had enough on my mind. Wait for 19 so that I can be clean. I want to basically make sure that I do this right. Yeah, come on, 19, where are you? Clean. Try this again. Have a look again. Wanna make sure. See, now we're getting a lot of stuff again. And now we're going to grep for execute again. Grep, execute. No trends. see again. What's going on? I should basically just test these all out. Grab the conf effect. So dbus daemon actually runs the conf. Dbus launch. And here it's actually, so it's actually that way. Damn, that's nasty. And dbus dbus d exacti is probably run by dbus launch. Yeah. So actually it was right. I was right in the first place. So let's just quit this first. So yeah, we need to go back, and it's actually logview is actually running dbus launch. But this shit, this is pretty messy indeed, because this, I was actually sure that dconf also runs it, so I'm overlooking something. Let's just log out and just take our time. It's really the only way. I started this stuff, so I'm going to have to also do it right, else I shouldn't have started it in the first place. Now it's also just 23, so I'm gonna have to wait a minute at least. 24. Messy, 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 all these transitions. But yeah, I want to make sure that those transitions actually go right. That's basically the fundamentals. If you have your transitions wrong, then everything goes wrong. So yeah, it's better to make 100% sure that you're clear about what's going on. But yeah, in the previous run, I was pretty sure that also dconf runs dbus launch. So that, but that was basically probably another scenario. Because you have this scenario where your password is cached, where you basically just authenticated 5 minutes ago, less than 5 minutes ago, and then it goes a different path. And if you basically need to authenticate, then it goes another different path. So you basically have two scenarios there that you need to take care of. 24. Now we supposedly clean. Log in. Oh, I'd be already logged in. Now we're getting all different scenario again. Every time it's just damn near different. Grab your execute no chance. Now we get very little. Let's have a look at these. So this is it actually shell that runs this? And it is actually shell that runs that. Is it actually shell that runs this? No, it isn't. So we need to take care of this one here, agent helper. But this is run by shell, so we can be sure of that. And we can actually use this type already. So, type enforcement file. Go all the way below. And create a policy kit out. I'll just use this policy kit out. And then require type. Yeah. And then call the policy kit out. We need to make sure that we have our transitions right. And then use something that's run by shell. So yeah, we're really opening up a can of worms here. But at least that's then one of our first setuids. It's a little bit interesting, not that boring stuff. And I use this executable file type here. That makes sure that's a transition. And then also check password. Now with regard to check password, we need to also be careful. To be careful there, because and this is pretty nasty, but I'm just going to add that as well. Check passwords. Because there's some bugs in SE Linux where the root okay where the root okay needs to be allowed, and that's nasty. Require type. A lot of domain transitions, a lot of new domains. But yeah, that was to be expected. That was to be expected. Out, it's running check password. It's not very efficient the way I'm doing it now, but sometimes I'm just not that efficient. The previous episode went really smooth, but yeah. And then check password. Or check PBD. PWD. Really important that you get your transitions right. I can't overstate that enough. I can't overstate that. Okay, so that should take care of that domain transition. Then basically log out again. And log back in hopefully before 35. Nope, of course not. Of course not. So I'm gonna have to wait to 36. That happens. You need to be patient. Because I need to be aware of the time. Because if I take AVC denial, if I use outsearch and I use overlapping time, then I might get confused by the AVC denial. So I really have to wait just another minute so that I can be sure that I'm clean. Don't want to make any stupid mistakes, if possible. And once I get these transitions out of the way, I also need to try it again with clear empty directories, because well, 36. So are we clean at 36? At least we're clean at 36. So these guys just neglected to add a quit button. So actually there is a quit button here. But if I maximize it, then there isn't. Now let's see if this makes it all a little bit, yeah, this makes it better. You see, because it's actually check password that reads shadow. And we have debus actually. Doing some stuff now. So now Debus is getting to the point where it's actually doing some nasty stuff. And we have a deck override for Debus launch. But other than that, I don't see any executes currently. You have a policy kit out doing the nasty stuff. So a lot of stuff here going on. A lot of it. Let's just first things first. So I take password. That stuff. Now I probably need to require this require class capability deck override, and that's probably because this is root. And root is probably traversing the user home directory. So because this is a setuid program, so this makes sense. I'm pretty sure this makes sense. I'm not going to look it up, although it would be a good lesson to look it up. But this makes sense because this check password is getting run by what is it? By policy kit out. And policy kit out gets run by that GNOME system log viewer, which is basically then transitioning on policy kit out, it's transitioning from the user to root. but it's still executing that from the user directory. And so to get the current PWD, it just needs to have the deck override, because the user home directory is basically for the user only, so root is not allowed to basically traverse that from an as a Linux perspective, at least. So yeah, that makes sense. And these are just I should probably require shadow t type shadow. This is the first time shadow that we do this. And I make a note here that probably needs password. Would okay. This is a bug. I'm not sure if it applies, but that's why I'm not adding it right away. But if it does apply, because at this point it's already, it's probably already root, running as root. And that's probably why this needs it, but I'm going to not add that right away. Back. Dbus. So let's have a look at this stuff. Grab sys resource. Grab sys resource. If this is actually dbus, then which it should be, then it's fine. And it's actually dbus, so this is fine. Okay, so we can basically add this. And this is actually dbus launch, isn't it? Dbus, or no, it's actually dbus itself. All right, so here we have dbus. Do we, where are, is our self rules? Here are our self rules. So I should basically probably just make a white space there, and I'll paste this in here so that I can basically have a look. So we have a dbus capability tool. We can leave those in, and a process set R set resource limit. So we can basically add that. Set resource limit. And then this also require that. And then we have a capabilities sys resource class capability, and we have sys resource, right? This resource, and we have capability to class capability to, and that's a block suspend. No, I'm not suspending, but okay, block suspend. So that takes care of those capability to. And then we have here this FIFO file. This is not sure why that is, but that's fine. And it set R limit. We can remove that from here. So yeah, this should take care of that. Let's have a look at not this stuff. What else we have? Dbus launch. So dbus launch is actually, let's have a look at user home, admin home t, grab launch, and then grab admin. Just, it's dbus. We're going to not do that right now, But we're going to take at least take care of one of them, of the deck override. But that's basically it. With regard to this creating this stuff, we're going to do that differently. So yeah, deck overrides this one here, and it's with regard to deconfig, I'm also going to have to do that differently. So dubious launch, dubious launch, and then just add deck override. We don't have a self yet, so that's the first one here. And with regard to deconf, we have a shell exec for G shell. Now this is probably check. This actually, let's have a look at that. G shell shell exec. So grep G shell and then shell exec. This is weird. It's probably dbus, isn't it? No, it's actually G shell GNOME shell checking that. Alright. G shell. And then we are going to add it. Here, we're going to do the following. We're going to don't out it the execute, but we're going to allow out it access. On to the next. This is weird. We're going to have to check that out. The syslog. The syslog. It's actually reading its own. File. So let's just add that here temporarily. So it's actually, besides the this one, it also needs this stuff. And then it reads proc, and it gets attribute of user home dir, and this can be removed. So it's actually searching. Search. Get attribute of both homebrew T and user homebrew T. This is basically traversing. What else? Oh yeah, with this logview stuff. A lot of stuff right here, but we can basically make that much cleaner. So logview. Now just paste it in here and then clean that up. Well, because basically what's happening is that a lot of this stuff here can be done, can be added easily. Farlog T, farlog. This is going to be removed. We're not not going to do that currently. Let's just do the basics first. Actually, let's just take care of the log files first, because that's a lot of mess. That's a big mess that we should basically just get rid of. So log file, let's just have a look. Do I have ASCII info t var log t and xt, and it's a log file. So what we can do is the following. We're going to require log file type log file. Jesus Christ. Type log file, that's actually all right, and it's actually an attribute. So damn man, it's like five mistakes and one go. And then what we're going to do is allow and then log file there, and then we're going to get attribute, search, open and read, so that it all can traverse and list all log file directories, and then basically read log files. So we can basically copy this over, actually use that, copy, paste, and then just edit that to read log file. Now this should allow us to get rid of a lot of stuff. For example, this can be removed anyways. I squeezy log, firewall D log, device kit log, network manager log. See, get rid of a lot of rules by just adding that, because the log viewer does what the log viewer does. Now I can make a comment there. Log viewer views logs. Okay, that makes sense, doesn't it? At least makes sense to me. So let's just oh, and I see that I left in some old craft here that I need to remove. Copy this over, because this is also reading fonts. Messy. Okay, so that's the font, so we can remove that here, from here. Then we have XServer, it connects, and this can be removed, XServer. Oh, this, yeah, that can be removed. Yeah, XServer. There's this stuff. And then that deconf stuff, that needs to be in there, but that's not for, that's for admin home T, so we need to basically add a new transition there. But we'll do that later. First things first. So yeah, this stuff. And this stuff, And then we have system db's var libd, which basically also needs to search var libd. So that's a get attribute and search. We have a deck override because it's running as root and it's basically its current pwd is in the user home directory fst, and then it's cache, and if I need to make sure that is, I'll leave that out for now. Yeah, so that's that. And then take care of pkexec and policy kit out. So we'll first remove this for now, but it's basically slash root. And here we have devlog, so it's basically logging to syslog. And we have here, this is weird. Hey, I'm going to take a small break. Be back very soon. Oh. Yeah. I'll save this if it allows me to. And then we'll be back soon.